Narcissists are interested in building networks. That's what they do. They're actually fantastic networkers. In their mind, the more people in their network, the more powerful they are as individuals. I'm reminded of my own experience in a network marketing business. Some people call it the pyramid scheme. No offense to you if you're in a network marketing business. It wasn't for me. And the reason it wasn't for me is because it's scripted in such a way to where you kind of have to view individuals as numbers. You just have to talk to people and sell them in and sell them in on this product and sell them in on the service and on the business. I believe that narcissistic individuals operate from that same principle. The only difference is they're not trying to recruit people to join a team to make money. They're trying to recruit people into their network of people to support them, people who look up to them, people who acknowledge them, people who, I don't know, adore them, worship them. So the way narcissists go about building their networks is to find like-minded people. How do they find like-minded people? Well, narcissists find like-minded people by doing what they do best. A, talking about themselves. B, by complimenting you. And C, by talking negatively about other people. Now, this is what I want to focus on. It's inevitable. When you're with a narcissistic individual, they will start talking about somebody else in a very negative way to you. And you may not even know who this person is. It could be someone they work with. It can be someone in their family. It could be someone in the neighborhood they're from. It doesn't matter. But they're going to paint, they want to paint to you a picture of what a pain in the butt this person is to them and how this person is ruining their life. There's two things going on simultaneously. One, obviously they're talking about somebody else, somebody who you don't even know probably, right? So whether or not you believe it, you are actually being an accomplice in the smear campaign of somebody else. That's exactly what's going on. Two, the other thing they're doing is they're testing you out to see if you are a good accomplice. They're testing you out to see if you will be a listening ear. Even by just being an active listener, to the narcissist, we're an accomplice. To the narcissist, we're cool, because they can talk to us about other people. So what happens down the road when we have a fallout with a narcissist, we have a disagreement, we decide that we really don't want to hang out with them as much anymore? Well, guess what? Because the narcissist has spent so much time talking to you about other people, the narcissist probably feels threatened. It's kind of like you know something about the narcissist that can take him out and take him down. So they start to view you as a rogue person in their network. They view you as a problem. You are an immediate threat and they need to get rid of you. They're gonna say whatever they can say to get you out of their network. But that's not good enough. They also have to sever your ties from everybody else in the network. They're gonna make sure that everybody in the network knows that there's something wrong with you. That's what's going on. In order to save their ass. That's what it's all about. To save their authority, to save their reputation, and to save their power over the network, the narcissist has to assassinate you. And the narcissist essentially does. It's called character assassination. That's it. That's what's going on. It's very difficult to fight against. By the time the smear campaign is happening to you, you're really left with no choice. If it's happening in a workplace, chances are you may have to get a new job. If it's happening in your neighborhood, you may have to disappear for a while. If it's happening in your family, you may have to cut ties with family members for a long time. This is how destructive the smear campaigning is, guys. It is insane. So how do you not get involved in the smear campaign? The way is to never get involved in the network to begin with. Right? So if any person ever comes up to you, doesn't matter if it's at work, doesn't matter if it's in the family, if someone comes up to you and starts talking about somebody else in a negative way, simply put your hand up and say, "Whoa, listen, I don't know that person, so I really am uncomfortable with this conversation." Put your foot down. Let them know right away that you are not somebody who will be an accomplice in gossiping or smear campaigning somebody else. If it's a narcissistic individual, they will be pissy with you. And they'll start going around probably and telling everybody, "Dude, that new guy, I thought he was cool. He's an asshole." Let him say that, because he has nothing else to go off of. He has nothing to twist. All he knows is that you're not somebody who is interested in playing games with people, right? So you may be come off as an asshole, but I'll tell you what, it's better to come off as being an asshole than to eventually be known as a twisted, perverted version of who you really are. Because you became friends with this individual, you became a part of their network, you shared some intimate things about yourself, maybe you shared some things about your life, you thought it was harmless, but it ended up you are now the target of their smear campaign, and now they're using everything they know about you in a twisted and perverse way to destroy you. I'd rather be an asshole right off the bat. I'd rather be the asshole that says, I don't like talking about other people. I'm sorry, I just don't. So I'd appreciate it if you would, you know, go share that information with somebody else. This is the only way to ever avoid being a part of character assassination and being targeted for a smear campaign. Guys, it's very destructive. It just depends on the type of narcissist you're dealing with. Some narcissists just will not quit. They'll be so convinced that they have to take you out that they will get their friends and their buddies to also ridicule, maybe come after you physically. Who knows? Guys, it's nasty.